scientist whose research led to the government imposing the lockdown has resigned after breaking his own social distancing advice to meet his lover.
But should people be able to meet their partners in lockdown because of the benefits to mental health? We're joined now by psychologist Emma Kenny from Manchester, who says the rules are contradictory and we should be allowed to see our partners, and psychologist Jo Hemmings from South London, who says it would cause a dangerous ripple effect that would spread the virus.
Emma, and we've done our own poll.
You can see what everybody's thinking. Let's have a look at it before we speak to both our psychologists. So far, 91.1% are saying that they haven't broken the lockdown rules to see their boyfriend or girlfriend, see their partners. So the majority, considerable majority, behaving. Emma, let's come to you because you actually think that these rules shouldn't have been in place in the first place. And actually, from a mental health perspective, being able to see our partners is more important than the protection of the health benefits?
I don't think it's that I think that people don't need to be protected. I think there are certain individuals who need to shield, and obviously it's a personal choice. I do believe in autonomy, and I think that the results are in about 332 people have died under the age of 45. So we do see that actually there are lots of people who potentially could be hanging out with their family members safely and actually benefiting from that. My big problem right now, because this is all I do, I literally spend my life working with people who are in mental distress acutely, and I do that both in an individual level and online. And I am telling you now, if you think that we are struggling right now, in the next 6 to 12 months, the rates that we're going to see regarding suicidality and all those things that go with it are going through the roof. They are now, from domestic abuse to suicide and all the other issues. And actually, the figures aren't playing out. So with respect to Mr. Ferguson, I'm not surprised he's broken his own rules because he's consistently got figures wrong and given us completely false representations of what we're facing. And right now, it's 2018 compared to 2020. We didn't have a pandemic then, but we understand that the figures right now are playing out in the fact that there were more deaths then. So I think it is contradictory, and I think that we have to make a call really shortly. I think that call has to be for the self-preservation of individuals who can connect with people that they love to save themselves from going any darker and deeper into a mental health abyss.
Well, of course, there's, you know, a very dark side, as you address. I would say, Emma Kinney, that under the rules, you are allowed to leave your house if it is to provide care for someone. So I wonder in those cases whether people could justify, look, if I don't have contact with this person, that person is going to be in severe distress. I mean, I think there is sympathy towards that. I certainly hope so. But Jo Hemmings, just on the basis of, you know, not being able to see somebody, you know, on a lighter level, you know, you just want to meet up with them, you need a cuddle and you quite like a hug.
Yes.
You think that people should be sticking to the rules?
I do. I think what's happening is we've gone from something called pro-social behaviour, which is where people are not perhaps being obvious and public about grouping together in parks and so on, not to antisocial behaviour, but something in the middle, which means it's them just saying, it's just me. Look, we've both been in lockdown for 2 weeks. I could just go and see my partner tomorrow. We're okay. And I think there's a lot of it's just me going on, out of frustration of all sorts, lockdown and everything else. But the problem there is, unless you are literally logging them in, tracking and tracing them, if you like, you don't know where your partner has been or who they might be flat sharing with, where they've been. So there's a real risk, but not in an obvious way, but in a much more subliminal way, that ripple effect of spreading the disease because people can't hold on till they see their lover for a few weeks is really very real.
But what Emma's saying, though, of course, is that we are on the verge of an abyss of mental health issues. There's huge problems that are around the corner off the back of where we are right now. And the way everybody's behaved up till now, Joe, the vast majority, 91% of our viewers saying that they haven't broken the rules at all to go and see a partner. Surely if the restrictions were lifted slightly and that was introduced, you could trust people to make sure that actually if they were going to come together, because the majority have adhered, they would adhere to the rules and make sure it was just their partner that they were seeing.
I agree. I'm not a killjoy here. I'm not trying to rain on anybody's parade. I think actually what's happened, your 91% saying they haven't is quite significant, because that's not 91% saying they wouldn't. So I think when those lockdown rules are relaxed, and we don't know the form of relaxation they're going to take, but I do think if that is allowable, permissible with somebody who has also been in isolation for a period of time, then I think it's okay. I think right now, and I think what Neil Ferguson did is very, very wrong, particularly as he's flying the flag for lockdown. I think at the moment, we just have to hold on and see what might happen by Sunday. But I think we probably shouldn't be doing it now, but I think there are people doing it now because they're getting fed up, I understand. However, it is a way of spreading that disease unwittingly, and it's the, you know, the physiological, epidemiological spread of it that bothers me. Psychologically, we should all be going out and seeing our lovers, because yes, that's absolutely would make us all feel a thousand times better. But unfortunately, at the moment, that isn't a possibility.
No, it's not. Emma Kenny, it's interesting, and I was talking to the Shadow Health Secretary, Jonathan Ashworth, yeah, and I know a lot of people respond in this way. He said, look, I don't want to get into the details of someone's personal life, but what the government did with the lockdown and separating couples was a massive intrusion into people's personal lives with extraordinary yeah consequences, wasn't it? So, I mean, actually, what Professor Lockdown does, as you know, directly connected with that, is relevant, I think, to people who are, as we see from the poll, abiding largely by this very strict rule.
I mean, I was applauding you because I was watching you when you were saying that, and you were absolutely correct, because the point is, you cannot have somebody in charge completely contradicting their behaviour, going around saying that you're all going to die, it's terrible, millions of you will be affected, getting the figures entirely wrong, and then actually just going ahead and carrying on with his partner as he chooses to see fit, and completely putting himself in a different position to the rest of us. I am completely on side there. But what I think that also suggests is that the need for human contact is just so powerful that even somebody who basically acts like a complete idiot in that situation, who's meant to be telling us all what to do, can't control himself. So how does that play out for the 91% of us who are consistently abiding by these rules, knowing it's impacting on our mental health, but also being affected by somebody who, now we've got to say, and let's be honest, it's so contradictory, the advice. Yeah. I can go to a supermarket and shop and touch things that somebody else has touched 2 metres away from me moments ago, but I can't actually go and hang out with my lover who I know has only been A, B and C. I can go back to work if I'm a key worker, but then I can't actually go and see my mother because actually that might be a problem, but she might be able to go because she's a key worker, but separately, we can't. It gets so beyond belief. And the problem is, human beings, particularly in human beings in the UK, we're very, very inquisitive. We're very curious. And when something doesn't add up, it doesn't add up. But what I can tell you is, from a mental health level, I have never been involved with so many people who are close to the brink. And I've spent my life working in this field. Yeah. I am terrified about this. And I think what you said and what you did is absolutely correct in that interview. You put them on the line. And really, the answer is this. Yes, you absolutely screwed up, Neil. Number two, you've lied to us as a population because the behaviour that you've just done is so contradictory. And three, why are we now being put in a situation where we're not allowed to acutely deal with our mental health by going and spending time with people that we love? We behave. We've proved that we behave. Let us out of lockdown in a very clear and honest manner.
Yeah, and Jo Hemmings, when people are being asked to do something so strict, not have contact with the people they love most, whose, you know, those relationships sustain, as Emma and you agree, those relationships sustain us. What does it mean for our behaviour when we see someone so high profile not sticking to the same rule?
Well, I think the trouble is we see behaviour and we're led by example. So there's a lot, as Emma says, there's so many mixed contradictory messages. Not only that, but they change on a daily basis as we kind of take a different strategy. And when we see somebody who has recommended, a scientist, we should be in lockdown, breaking his own lockdown, I mean, that is just a hall pass for human behaviour to go out and follow it. And we get why. I get why he's done it. He needed to see. It was his mistress, I believe. But he needed that physical contact. And it is literally saying, yes, he's giving us the example that we naturally, subconsciously follow. It's just, it's shocking, and it's just another example, as Emma says, of the mixed and contradictory messages that we're getting, which does not help with the psychological mental welfare of the people in this country. If they could get one straight message, even if we didn't like it, it's much easier to focus on that and understand it and work our way through it than it is to get several different conflicting messages, often within a couple of days.